customer service challenge.
I'm recording.
That's the topic. So 68% of customers, out of 100, 68% of customers believe that a polite customer service agent is the key to providing great service. You know, when you are polite, you can provide a customer service well. You know, so if you are not polite, there is no way you can actually solve the issue of customer service. I told you the other day, when we start, you will come across highly customers. An highly customer that difficult customer, that means the hungry ones. The high customers, there are those angry customers. They are not happy at all. So we have also have the difficult ones. These are people that you meet. You will start operating fully. So if you want your customers to come back to your business, you need to do what? Satisfy them well. You need to treat them well so that they will be happy. Otherwise, they will come your office. Now, we will discuss 12 common service challenges. 12 common service challenges that face daily, that face customer service daily. Number one.
12 common service challenges.
Yes, that face customer service on a daily. Number one. Number one,
let me come near.
Not having an answer
voice.
To the queries. Not having an answer to the queries. Not having an answer to the queries. What it means is that under it, you have handling this challenge. That is what that means. From that number one, not having an answer to the customer's queries. Under it, you have handling these challenges is more about what solution. It's more about what you should not do than what you should do. Handling this challenge is more about what you should not do than what you should do. You see? There are things you are meant to do when customers give you some things. There are things you are not meant to do. Do you understand? Now, the key is to avoid being unclear in your response. How do we be unclear? You want to be outspoken. If you must talk to any customer, that is what I was telling you now. What happened yesterday? When Clara was called now, come and tell us what you have at the marketplace. So we're talking to herself. You understand? So you assume that people here by listening are your customers. Do you understand? They're your customer. So you want to be clear for whatever things that you are saying. Because when you are clear, anything you are doing, being maybe you are outside doing marketing, you want to muster the courage to talk to customers. You understand? You talk to the customer. This is what we have. This is the product. This is what we are selling. This is what we have in this site. Do you understand? But sometimes when you are not bold enough to talk to customers, that means if they ask a question,
they assume you don't know.
They will even buy. They ask a question and not trouble. But sometimes when you are bold enough to talk to them, they will be short of words. Do you understand? They will just say, okay, let me just register. Do you understand? I was telling you the other day, the first time we went for registration, I told you people, they drove me out of their shop. Do you understand?
I can't have it. I was with Corona. So what you need?
We are fraudsters. Do you understand? So these are the things you need to meet. So you have to talk, talk and convince people. So.
Can I ask a question there?
Yeah.
What if you try your possible best to convince a customer and the person doesn't want to comply? The person can give you an insult. How can you handle it?
You leave the person. Like the one that drove me away. Maybe in time to, come, maybe we'll get the awareness. Do you understand? That man came to discuss with me that day. It's true. You understand? And that is why they are trying to push up this median jingle, what kind of thing, so that they get the awareness, you know, this thing, so that they will be aware of what we are doing. Now, if you do not have the answer, like as you said now, acknowledge the question, difficult, guys. Acknowledge, you can write to, if you do not have the answer, acknowledge the question, difficulty. If you do not have the answer, comma, acknowledge the question, difficulty. That the question the customer told you is difficult. You understand? That what the customer told you is difficult. So acknowledge it. You understand? Ask them for a time to find a solution. Ask them for a time to find a solution. Then, guarantee, you will contact them. You see that? You don't guarantee the person, yes. Don't worry, we will contact you. That's for that number one. Number two, transferring calls to another department. Talk about this one. What did you say the other day? Two of you that were here. Transferring calls. Transferring calls to another department. Now, under it, there will be time when the best way to help a customer is to transfer customer call. There will be a time when the best way to help a customer is to transfer the customer to another person. The essence of it, because maybe you will find difficulty in answering that call or provide a solution to the request of the customer or to the complaint of the customer. Now, when that happens, you first need to let your customer know you are transferring them to someone that will help. You have to let the customer know that you are transferring their call to another person for help. But as you are doing it, avoid the mistake of being a blind transfer.
To somebody who doesn't know it,
You understand?
Okay.
As you are doing it, as I give you this phone to this person, avoid what?
A blind
transfer. Meaning, you transfer the customer to your teammate without verifying. Meaning, you transfer the customer to your teammates without verifying they are valuable to take the call. Do you understand? Now, you know, sometimes we are with a customer call us or we answer call that we get want to actually give the phone to another person. You're not even sure
yes.
that the customer is there. First, I will give the solution. It's not there. Okay, so let me go to that office and have done blind transfer. You understand?
Yes.
So you have to be sure. Let the person, you be aware that the person that you want to transfer the call to is there.
It's around.
Do you understand? Yeah. It's around before you do that. Otherwise, you will end up causing customer satisfaction.
The blue scammer.
Maybe you have transferred the customer away.
Okay, that place.
Please, yeah.
Meaning you transfer the customer to your teammates. Meaning you transfer the customer to your teammates without verifying they are valuable. Without verifying that they are valuable to take their call. Failing to understand what customer wants. Failing to understand what customer wants. You know what I need to do? See, you are not customer service, you are marketer. The marketer, you see now, let me tell you, we start now, everybody here. Not many you are from customer service, marketer, admin, all this, everybody will go into the field. Everybody will enter the field. You don't have to market. No exception, no. So you have to go. That is why, okay, those of you that have not got in marketing. I've given these people, okay, your site. People that will cause you problem. People that are not buying much thing. Maybe they want to buy something of 2,000 naira. They will be there, all over the places. Do you understand? At the end of the day, your management will start questioning you. Do you understand?
Yeah.
What is the problem? Answer the issue. Now, failing to understand what customer wants. Under it, customer can have a hard time. A hard time explaining what they want. Have you ever contacted any customer that is stammerer? Is stammerer? Do you know a stammerer?
Yeah.
Somebody that wanted to explain himself but was not able to explain himself and they find it difficult to talk to you. Yeah?
Even somebody who is not a stammerer.
And somebody would say maybe he's not even educated, cannot even express himself. And he cannot even express that thing that they want to tell you. So you have to work patient with this one. Patient with this one. Listen to them so that you can help them. Now, they may not know the technical character. They may not know the technical jargon. They are not ready today.
How
do you eat?
Why can't you do it right
now? Yeah, you all know. I'm doing it before you, but I'm coming here to tell you people. If you do it more than your teammate, I now know it more than you. Yeah? Then, there are 20 people KPI. You forgot to. What is KPI? Key Performance Indicator. That is where they will not rate each other, every one of you. You understand? You forgot to now. Now, if you are not doing what you are supposed to do, the management will not judge you KPI.
Keep again.
KPI.
K-P-I. Okay, KPI. Okay.
Key Performance Indicator. That's where they checkmate your performances in whatever thing you are doing in this place. Maybe as your head will now appraise you through them. You understand? They will look at you and say, no, these people, it's not you well. They will make sure, Say, what about Modesta?
No, don't do that. The lady, she's not actually trying. Do you understand? Or this one. Where are we?
They may not know the technical
jargon. They may not know the technical jargon to tell you exactly when the problem is. Like what I explained now. They don't know
how
that thing they want to, in fact, that thing they want to tell you. Do you understand? So you have to be patient with this one. So if possible, what do you do? Ask the customer to take you step by step through their issue. Ask the customer to take you step by step through the issue. Do you understand?
Yes.
This one can apply to any customer now.
Sir.
It's one of the point there that even when they are angry, you are talking to you like this. You do what? You make calm. And after which, do what? Ask the customer, tell the customer all those things you have said before.
Wait,
let them say it one after the other. Now, you might find it helpful to take notes while you explain. You might find it helpful to take notes while they explain. What do I see on your that time?
So
that you pick pick notes, pick a paper. Yeah?
And jot down.
If they call you or phone, those or that they are coming in contact with you face to face. And they're talking, do what? Jot down the main points. That jotting down will help you to be able to solve that
problem.
So it's very, very, very important. Now, consider sharing the problem with the teammates. And sometimes, the issue might be difficult for you to handle. Do you understand? So what do? You share it what? With your teammates. Maybe then, four of you pull heads together and provide a solution. The second opinion will help you solve the issue quickly. Is it not? So when you talk to your neighbor about the issue, they can quickly tell you, please, this thing, do it like this, do it like this, this is how you do it. You understand? You will now have the help and see how you can help what your customer. Otherwise, if you just leave the customer like just like that, that means you have caused a problem. You don't have help, you don't have solution to their requests. That is for that. Number four. I told you all this one, I'm not taking you for now. It's a kind of maybe a recap of all everything that we have talked so far.
Yeah?
But it's not telling you a way you can now do what? Provide your help. Now, dealing with hungry customers. See where this is all come now? Dealing with what?
Hungry
customer. And a hungry customer is an high-rate what?
Customer.
That's
an
high-rate customer. It's an angry customer. That's just the meaning. So this is what becomes the opposite. The explanation to the meaning. You understand? So, dealing with what? But it's not how you are dealing with them. But remember, in the other one, say when an angry customer is talking, or is angry, you do what? You
remain calm.
But what do you do? Those type of people, there are some qualities that need to express towards them. Now, see, even the best company get calls from angry customers.
Get
calls. Even the best company so far get cost, call from hungry customers. Two of us. There's no company I'm serious. They have not received any call from any hungry customer. What thing or the other must happen? And that customer will rubbish that company first. Even in the face of that rubbish, the company will still calm the customer down. Why is it so? Because the customer, they are what? They are the king.
They are important.
They are important to you, and people pay your salary. So when they call you like this, yeah, they are even hungry. You calm them down though. If someone is selling something, they are selling something. If you are hungry with your customer, the customer will go away.
Not even, not even go away, can punish your...
No, now, as he's going, if you treat the customer badly, as he's going, 10 customers are still following that only with that one again. Because it's good to tell another person, say,
yes, don't go there. They are not treating people.
Do you understand? Mm. And for those 10 now, one of it will tell another person again. Another one, this one, another person again. Yeah. Sometimes you ask yourself a question, say, angry customer. Now, the key is... First, to calm them. The key word there is to first calm them. Calm them down. Calm them down so you can find out how you can help them. You see now? Calm these hungry ones down so that you can see how you can help them. Stop. Continuation. One approach is to use the head technique. Head. Not the head, oh. I hear you. I head.
Okay, here.
Head, or I head. That's what technique. Yeah? We're going to see how I'm going to figure each one after the other by alphabet, what it means. Head technique for helping customer. What does it mean? You cannot write, you go to a different line. Write H dot.
What? H.
H.
You go down. Don't write it together. H, please. If you write H, go to the next line.
Okay.
Ish. Mm-hmm. Go to the next line. Mm-hmm. Write E.
Next line.
Next line, write A. Next one, write R. The next one, write D. As head, not so?
Head.
Now, the H stands for year.
D.
The H.
Okay.
Stands for
year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The E stands for empathize.
Empathize.
Sorry? Emphasize.
Okay,
emphasize. The A stands for apology.
Apology.
Apology. The arrow stands for resolve. 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 The D stands for diagnose.
Again.
Diagnose.
Diagnose.
Now, look at it now. This energy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are 5 qualities. If you have these tips or figure things, when a customer talks, an angry customer talks, through phone or face-to-face contact, remember to do what? You make calm and hear what the customer has to tell you. Customer might be stranded or might be, let's say, by one way or the other, stranded one way or the other. You do what? You empathize. You show sympathy. Do you understand?
Emphasize. Okay.
Emphasize.
Okay.
Emphasize on their needs.
You explain them.
You explain them. Empathy doesn't matter. Now remember, under take responsibility. Whatever things customer says, you take what?
Yes.
Take the responsibility. If they insult you or something went wrong, go wrong, apologize for this customer. so that you don't lose them. Find a way to resolve their problem. Don't shy away. Always try to listen and resolve their issue. Now, number five. This one is one of the, let's go, exceeding customers' expectation. Exceeding customer expectation. How do we exceed customer expectation? We have said it several times. It's not like you're sleeping. How do we exceed customer expectation? There are things that customer want. I told you about issue. In the last one we treated that time, I was telling you about how long are we meant to treat customer issue to resolve customer issue.
24 hours.
We have 48 hours, I suppose.
Yes.
2 days to resolve this complaint. Now among the 48 hours, you will now resolve customer's complaint or issue. Your issue pass issue. Complete pass it complete. You understand? You now resolve it within the allotted time. Maybe within the 48 hours you resolve customer issue in less than a day. You have beat what? You have beat the expectation of the customer. You have exceeded the expectation because hopefully the customer will be expecting it in 2 days' time. I'm expecting this.
Response.
You understand? Or like maybe in the bank now, ATM debited you. And now, let me tell you, you within the bank this thing, they're spending within 48 hours. But you know too well that it's 24 hours for eternal this thing. You understand? Eternal account is 24 hours. And now, customer now got the reversal within 24 hours, not 48 hours. Will that customer not be happy? We'll be happy. Now, the trick, garage. The trick to beating the challenge is to set reasonable customer expectation. The trick to beat or beating this challenge is to set reasonable customer expectation. Stop. Then meet and exceed them. Then meet and exceed them. Full stop.
Meet and what?
Exceed them.
Pass. Pass.
Have you heard this one before? This is a different this and now continuation. Exceeding expectation can generate repeat business. Are you getting it now?
Yes.
Exceeding what? Expectation can generate what?
A repeat
business. So when you when you exceed customer's expectation, I mean that customer will still come back to you.
Generate
repeat business. You see now? So you have to treat them well. You understand? People that sells in the shop and here and there. So customers that want to buy, they are seeing the product here, but they will leave here to get it to go and buy from their customer. Do you understand? Because of how
they treat them.
Do you understand?
So like we did our online shopping. Even if somebody buys something of 2,000 naira online, the logistic will stay the 500. Or is it depending on the size of the goods that the person
has? I think they are still working on that thing, but they will find that we explain that very well. You understand? What I know, like what I taught people, from that side you are seeing, is competitive. You understand? For you to have a repeat business on that site, Ebano is not the only site that you can buy and sell. We have Amazon, we have DG, we have the Junior and so on. You understand? Now, from that size now, I told you about pricing. You understand? I'm selling this phone 10,000. The same product of phone. Yeah? It's 10,000 in Evano. Hmm? The same product of phone is in Jumia. It's been sold how much? 20,000. If you go to the other man, it's been sold 15,000. Where will we go?
15,000.
You go and buy the one at the cheaper. But it's the same products.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Remember, anybody that wants to upload any goods to this site must not upload something that people will be able to buy. I will show you the other day. Shoe. You see shoe now. Hmm? Some person, let's say some person, like there's a shoe there, 350,000. It's on that shoe there. Okay, let's say we have a shoe of, let's say, 75,000. And that shoe, if you go to market and price it by yourself, maybe that shoe will be sold, instead of 75,000, you buy it 60,000 or 50,000. Because nobody will go to price the item there. Do you understand? They're not fixing some amount. But remember, the site will be competitive. It's way cheaper. That is where it goes faster. But they are the same product. Yes. So the key is to doing that, the key way of doing that. For customer to repeat business, the key way for doing that is customer-centric approach. Is customer-centric approach.
Customer-centric approach.
That is marketing
term.
It says spell it.
Centric now, C-E-N-T-R-I-C. Hmm? Customer centric approach.
Customer
centric.
Centric.
Huh?
No. It's a
moment. You just put small iPhone at the middle. Do you understand? The way you approach, that's what matters. Customer service is approach. Behavior, that's why we are pushing it. Do you understand? Your approach on handling things matters. You might go to this customer and say, you want to go and market this customer. You are talking with this customer. Yeah? He's not listening to you. Do you understand? He's even tired. But this lady will go there and talk to this customer now. We do what? We list it. That is what we are saying. She will win the heart of that customer. So if you don't know how to approach, have a good approach on customer, that means you will find it difficult to sell your product, your brand. You understand? So that thing alone is good for every, in fact, each and every one of us. Learn how to convince, how to market, and how to approach. Listen, not that we don't use it, instead of using the customer, you don't even be a customer. It's not okay. That approach is wrong now. Do you understand? So anybody that wants to do business, you have to believe in yourself. Do you understand? Since the customers are the key, tell them, is it difficult for you to say sorry?
Yes.
Is it difficult for you to say you see a little one? You are even easier than the little one. Can't you tell the customer, good morning, good afternoon, good evening? Is it difficult?
No, it shouldn't.
You greet the person well. I greet the person. You talk to the person as if you are talking to a friend that I've met before. Do you understand? You listen to him. Mm-hmm. Remember, sometimes we still have a language barrier, even though I am only not understanding it. But I can convince them.
How can you do that?
Well, you know,
by sign?
I was talking about those Hausan men in artisan. But as it did now, you can easily convince all of them. If you really want to market, you understand? You have good numbers of returns in your in your referral code. Try to convince them.
You show them.
You understand? Me, the head, talk to the head. And lure all of them in confusion. You understand? Not the fool here because they will enjoy it. They will enjoy it. We have real estate on that side. When they are building now, they will now be looking for what? An artisan. Why don't you just call them through the site and give them the job? How many years are we going to be? The only one? No, nah. As you are building this one, another one is still coming, another request is still coming. People will come to you now, in this office, come and build this house for us. So many of them. So you will not take people from the side, people that have registered. Collect them, come and work here. Do you understand? Work here, they will be happy. How many of them will stay to stay down the morning to evening, they will get a job. And when somebody come want to pick them up, they will rush. Okay, I mean. Do you understand? How many people will they pick again? Now you are not collecting, you are collecting 40 once. Collecting 40 once. Who they become here? You know outside people, yeah? They can convince their brother. Do you understand? If truly what you are doing is okay, money is coming, they will bring other. Do you understand? But in my decide that for a renewal, I mean for a registration, it will take only a period of 6 months.
Okay, please, for my own benefit, I want you to explain that registration for me. Let me know.
Guys, for them to have access to our site.
Yes.
That they want to come there as an artisan. Artisans are people who say all these big players.
And
all these electricians. You understand? Yeah. Now, I want this company to call me. I give me the job. Hey, they thought people were saying now somebody that registered as an artisan now. Like I register somebody in this site now, it's a dry cleaner. They give me this dry cleaner service. Now, for that person, you register with $2,500. It's already on that site. Now, I will show you the site you see it. You know, they didn't show you how to create a job.
Yes.
This way, group. How to create job, artisans.
No.
Show you that.
No.
But I'll show you, I will log on to somebody's edition. You see it. These ones, you can create a job there. And bring the three service. One plus, plus three. $150. You understand? Ah, you will see $150 and $200. You understand? Alright, we just click at that.
Okay.
You understand?
As in, is it for the a day job pay?
One, man. Just a workshop, so man.
Okay, workshop.
You are paying the job, man. People to come out there. That's artisans. But the long way around, personally, like people that want to build us, all those big layers, you not call them. You have their details here, online. You call them, you take them to the site. You understand? So you have to register with $2,500 as an artisan. Do you understand?
And those registered people will be called for jobs.
No, I'm just talking about artisan. That is that session. That is artisan. People will see all those electricians, mechanics, those people. Seller, man. That's not seller.
They already started.
Then generate data that tells you exactly what customers want. Now, not data we're talking about. It's a use prints. You can continue. Use prints, comma.
Prints.
Prints. Comma. Electronic. Comma. And social media. to produce that kind of data. To produce that kind of data. Which one? This is only electronics. Mm-hmm. Like when you are doing your this now.
That's in print.
Number six. Is it too much?
It's not too much. Right on.
No, I'm taking my time just to explain to you. Okay. Number six. See on that big one again. Serving multiple customers. Number six, serving multiple customers.
Okay, serving, okay.
How do we serve multiple customers? Multitask. Yes. How do you multitask? We can talk. How do we multitask? How do we serve customers, customer at the same time? Plenty of customers. Maybe they come to you face to face. You have. You have 4 here, and for you are still on phone. Because you do more phone calls, how do you set them?
You will tell them to cool down. You are coming to them one by one. You cool down and attend to them one by one.
Thank you. What's supposed to tell us more? These two people are supposed to be saying it because I thought three people. On a phone conversation.
Sir?
In the customer service area desk, you are not using this type of phone.
Yes,
sir. You use that table phone, you use the table phone. On that table phone, we have what's called mute. That was called place call on hold. Yeah, well. I thought you were not. Were you not here? Were you not here? You were here. Yeah? No, let's explain. Place customers calls on hold in a mindful way. But then, see, for multitasking, you can be doing this is the system now. Yeah? You can open different pages. Yeah? Of area where you work. Do you understand? If you are taking this request from this page, you can as well attend to another person from another page. You minimize that you are working. You understand? Mm-hmm. And even a phone call, you can sit up. Like 3 things or 4 things at a time. You use your hand and work, you use your ear to listen and talk to your mind. So you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's see what we have.
Brain is good, they work, they well, well.
That's why you need to be agile every time. You know, I told people on which one, when I said, you know, okay, that's mine. That you are working. In the morning, your face will be bright.
Yes.
When you come to maybe between 11 and 12 or 1,
mm-hmm.
your face will look dim. Is that true? Your
12,
face will come together. Mom.
You mean 12 noon or 12 a.m.?
12 noon.
In the morning when you come to work now.
Okay, okay.
You will be agile and you'll be working. You understand? You're okay. You understand? You're okay. Well, as you're working.
Mm.
Remember, before you begin today's work, look for something to eat. So that you can share. Eat food. You understand?
Yes.
Then, secondly, food cannot cause that face to be like that at a time. At times. Sometimes, your sitting position makes you
tired.
Your back will be paining you.
Mm-hmm.
Your leg. You be paining one kind, swelling up, your eye, the same thing. Do you understand? What do you do? Stand up and do a walk.
Take a walk.
2 minutes. Come and sit. Allow blood to flow in your body. So that you still maintain the same type of face you started this morning. Do you understand? Now, totally, even when you stood or you stand up from your desk in the afternoon, you want to go and eat. Yeah? Don't eat overdose. Because if you decide to eat overdose, when you sit down, when you come back to your desk, then she will blow you there. You doze off. So what should I do? Shoes now?
Now I have trouble. You go chop. Now I have trouble.
Now
I have trouble. Now. Is something that is okay for you now? But not eat overdose. Most of us can eat overdose.
Anyway, in Nigeria now, there is no overdose again.
Yeah.
In Nigeria now, there is no overdose.
You understand? When you eat that type of thing, do you know why you feel sleepy? That time, you let your seat go and eat. You must have gotten a little bit tired. You understand? So when you now take food inside now, and go back, fan is blowing you, this is blowing you, that tiredness will now work on you. You understand? Goes off. You'll be yawning, open your mouth. What's wrong with me before you like this, you open mouth? Huh? It is not good. They are going through. That is called what?
I wasn't recording.
Empathy. This is now. What's your name? Huh? Merit. You don't want to pay attention, you are pressing your phone. Assuming your CEO is around and seeing you pressing phone, I don't think we'll be happy with you. Baba and Baba communication. Do you understand? Where you see this, the way someone that is there, there's no way you can be the person Baba. Do you understand? You smile and wave.
And wave.
These are things people know. You should know them so that where they are being affected, you know the angle that's coming from. So you look at it. Why are you coach? This time when you want to sleep out. Sorry. Now, so apologize. Remember, do not fail to apologize to any inconveniences. You understand? So, I was saying your time now, charity begins to what?
At
home. What you learn here, it affects your life. You understand? What you portray in your house, that maybe if you are not tired, that doesn't take nonsense. And when you are coming, when you come to that gate, when you get to that gate, remove that coat of
nonsense
and put it down that gate and enter here with a clean hand. So when you are here, you can smile to anybody you see. Now, yeah, we now. Okay, also, provide constant updates. Constant updates. Provide constant updates. That constant updates. Maybe you're addressing the public now, your customers. Like what they used to do in the bank. Say once every 30 minutes. Update. You see, also, we are sorry for the inconveniences. Please bear with us. Do you understand? We are working on it. Keep on reminding your customer every what? 30 minutes. Every 30 minutes to help them reassure previous customer. What else question? You understand? Every 30 minutes. And it will help them. Those ones who say, with the fear, say something to help me out there. They will make their mind, they will calm down. You understand? So once everything is over, you cannot publish a new message after the, that sorry for the complaint. That now you are telling them that sorry. You understand? Sorry.
No problem.
It's not restored.
Thank you.
You understand? You not tell them. Publish on the news. Number 8. She will stop here, sir, so tomorrow we'll take the round.
You can finish it. Tomorrow you will begin another thing. Tomorrow you begin
you're
another
hungry.
Thing.
Hungry, okay. So now we hope we will not talk about this now. Hungry don't come. Leave where they talk now, not the hungry.
Finish.
Tomorrow.